Hello, my name is Ashley Sieber, and I teach 4th grade math and science at Rocky Hill Elementary School. I am also a demonstration teacher for the math department. Although I currently teach 4th grade, I taught 3rd grade for 5 years prior to moving to 4th grade this past year. Today, we will be reviewing all the different standards you should have learned with fractions in 3rd grade this year. Let's dive in. So today we are going to be reviewing all the different standards you learned about in fractions in 3rd grade. So we will talk about our first standard, understanding what a fraction is, and that a fraction is a quantity formed by one part when a whole is partitioned into b equal parts. Those are your unit fractions. We'll also understand that a fraction a over b as the quantity formed by parts of size 1 over b. For example, 3/4 represents a quantity formed by 3 parts of size 1/4. We're also going to be reviewing fractions on a number line. Understanding that a fraction is a number that you can represent on a number line. And the last part of our fraction standards is finding the equivalence of fractions and explaining those. Knowing what the word equivalence means and comparing fractions by reasoning about their size. So we're going to start with the basics. First, what is a fraction? Well, we learned in 3rd grade that a fraction is a number on a number line that represents equal parts of a whole. So we also learned that fractions where the numerator, that's the top number on our fraction, is smaller than the denominator, that's the bottom number of our fraction. All of those fractions are between the whole numbers 0 and 1. Isn't that crazy that we learned that there are numbers that are smaller than 1 but bigger than 0? That is pretty crazy. So as we said, our numerator is our top number. Our denominator is our bottom number. So our unit fractions are all fractions that have our numerator being 1. It's one part of the whole. No matter how many pieces it's divided up into, you can see this triangle is divided into 2 pieces. One part is shaded, so the numerator is 1. There are 2 equal parts, so the denominator is 2. This is the unit fraction 1/2. Moving to our square, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 equal parts. Still, one part is shaded, but there are 4 equal parts. So this fraction is 1/4. Moving to our circle, we have 1, 2, 3 equal parts, and only 1 shaded. 1 shaded, 3 equal parts. So we call that fraction 1/3. So when we think about looking at a picture and representing this picture with a fraction, we have to think about 2 different things. We have to think about how many parts are there in the whole. Are they equal parts? If they're not equal, can I represent a fraction? Nope. So if I'm looking at this picture, I see that all the parts are the same size. It looks like a pizza. How many parts are shaded? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 shaded parts. That is my numerator. To find my denominator, I have to think, how many total equal parts are in one whole? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 equal parts in that whole. So this picture represents the fraction 4/6. So we can also draw a picture to represent a fraction. Let's draw a picture to represent the fraction 2/3. First, I have to know what those numbers in the fraction mean. I know that the numerator tells me the number of parts that we're talking about. In this case, we're going to shade 2 parts. So we're going to shade 2 parts. The denominator tells me the number of equal parts in the whole. So So I know that I'm going to make a picture with three equal parts. Three parts. That's kind of a hard one. Let's make a circle. I'm going to draw a circle, and I'm going to separate my circle into three equal parts. One, two, three. Now, to represent this picture as two-thirds, I need to color two parts to show part of that whole. I'm not going to color the whole circle. That would be three-thirds. So I'm going to color two parts of that circle. Two parts are shaded, three equal parts. That picture represents two-thirds. So we can also represent fractions on a number line. First of all, we know that a number line is a line with numbers at equal intervals. So since fractions are numbers, we can put fractions on a number line just like we do whole numbers. All of our proper fractions that we've been working with, that's a fraction that the numerator is smaller than the denominator, all of those fractions fall between 0 and 1. So I have a number line here. Let's see what fractions can fall on this number line. First, I have to think, how many parts is my number line separated into? Between the whole numbers 0 and 1, how many equal parts are there? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This number line is separated into sixths. So I know that each part represents 1/6. Remember, those are our unit fractions. So each of those parts represents 1/6. I can also count on my number line. If I start at 0 and made one jump, that means this point would be 1/6. If I keep going, now I've made two jumps. So this point would represent 2/6. How many jumps have I made now? 3. This point would represent 3/6. What fraction is at this point? That's right, 4/6. What about this one? 5/6. Can I name a fraction that is the same as one whole? Sure, I can call one whole 6/6. Notice that the numerator and the denominator are the same. Any fraction where the numerator is the same as the denominator is equal to one whole. Just like we used a picture to represent a fraction, we can also use a number line to represent a fraction. Let's put 5/7 on a number line. First I have to think, what two whole numbers does 5/7 come between? I know my numerator is smaller than my denominator, so all of those proper fractions will be between 0 and 1. So, let's draw a number line. Remember, a number line can continue on without the numbers that I'm drawing. I put 0 on the left and 1 on the right. Okay, now I have to think, if I want to show 5/7 on this number line, how many parts do I need to separate my line into? I'm going to look at my denominator for that. Here is my denominator. I'm going to separate this number line into 7 equal parts. That might be a little tricky to make them equal, but I'm going to do my best. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7. Sometimes it's really helpful to go back and count the number of parts you've made in your number line to make sure you have the right number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Now I need to think, where would 5/7 fall on this number line? I'm going to look at my numerator for that. Remember, my top number is called the numerator. And I see that my numerator is a 5. So I'm going to make 5 jumps starting from 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This point on the number line is 5/7. Now we're going to discuss equivalent fractions. Fractions that are equivalent are different fractions that name the same amount of the whole. Let's show that in a model. Let's show the fractions 1/4 and 2/8. Let's see if they're equivalent. First, let's show 1/4. To draw a model of 1/4, I need to first look at the denominator. The denominator is 4. That tells me that I break up my shape into 4 equal parts. I like to start with halves. I have 2 equal parts, and then I can break each of those parts into 2 parts as well. 4 equal parts. To show 1/4, I'm going to color 1 of those equal parts. Now let's show 2/8. Again, I look at my denominator to know how many parts I need to break my shape into. I see my denominator is 8, so I'm going to break the shape up into 8 parts. Again, I like to start with halves. So I start with half, 2, and then I break it up into 4s. And then I can break each 4th into 2 parts, 2, 4, 6, 8. That will be 8 parts. To show 2/8, I color 2 parts. 1, 2. Now, to think if these are equivalent, I have to ask myself, do they show the same size of the whole? So, let's look at 1/4. 1/4 starts here and goes to the first part. So right here is 1/4. If I draw a line from where it ends down into the 2/8, I see that it meets the 2/8, and those two shaded parts are the same size. So 1/4 is equivalent or equals to 8. I can also show equivalent fractions on a number line. Let's show 1/4 on the top number line and 2/8 on the bottom number line. When using a number line, it's very important to make sure that my whole numbers are at the same point on both number lines. So I like to mark the zeros at one time and then the ones. 0, straight down, 0. Again, on this side, 1 and 1, making sure that we're the same distance apart. Now let's show 1/4. And I know that if I want to show 1/4, I have to think, how many parts do I break up my number line into? I look at my denominator for that. My denominator is 4. So I'm going to break this number line into 4 equal parts. I'm going to start with half and separate both halves into 2 parts, and then that will give me 1, 2, 3, 4 parts. To show where 1/4 is on this number line, I'm going to look at my numerator. My numerator is 1, so I'm going to make 1 jump to show where 1/4 is. I'm going to start at 0, 1 jump, here is 1/4. Now, let's show 2/8 on my bottom number line. Again, I look at my denominator to tell me how many equal parts I need to divide my number line into. My denominator is 8, so I need to separate this number line into 8 equal parts. I'm going to start with half. To make 8, I'm going to need 4 parts on this side and 4 parts on this side. So I can go half of each one of those again. 2, 4, 6, 8, so I can separate each one of these 4 parts into 2 parts. I'm going to count to make sure I have 8 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, I'm going to make 2 jumps, because my numerator is 2, to show where 2 eighths would be. Starting at 0, 1, 2. Here is 2 eighths. And I can see, if I draw a line straight from 1/4 through 2 eighths, they are at the same point on my number line. So again, I have proven that 1/4 is equivalent to 2/8.
So now that we've reviewed all of our fraction standards, it's time for some practice. In your packet, on the Knox School's at-home packet for fractions, you should have several pages of work that you can work through that goes through each of the fraction standards. Remember, if you get stuck, you can always go back and watch a portion of the video. If you would like a challenge, come back to this part of the video. If the large hexagon is one whole, then what fraction of the whole would be one green triangle? What fraction of that whole hexagon would be one red trapezoid? And then what fraction of that whole would be one parallelogram? That's a pretty big challenge. See if you can do it. Have fun!